When I was a kid, I would go out of my way to learn everything that could be learned about dinosaurs. It was a subject that always fascinated me. I ended up getting my hands on a lot of dinosaur documentaries and would watch them endlessly. And one that I was particularly fond of was a Discovery Channel production called When Dinosaurs Roamed America. Similar to Walking with Dinosaurs, it attempts to recreate the prehistoric world and takes viewers from the early stages of the dinosaurs to their extinction. In fact, you could call it the American equivalent of Walking with Dinosaurs. The dinosaur effects are very well done, not only in looks, but also in behavior. The way they constantly bob their heads, sniff the air, and scan the world around them, I have absolutely no trouble believing that these are real creatures with minds of their own. The narration is done by John Goodman, which I will admit can be a little distracting since it is difficult to hear his familiar voice and not picture him in the recording studio, but fortunately he doesn't try to steal the show and turn the narration into a performance like most celebrity narrators do. He just reads the script in his normal voice, which is all that's really needed.
Triceratops are plant eaters. They roam the plains in herds, grazing on ferns and small trees like palmettos, while keeping an eye on their young.
What I love most about the movie is the tone. It allows the audience to become immersed in the environment, and it's definitely not afraid to give the narration an occasional break and let the visuals speak for themselves. Every now and then, it does cut to interviews with paleontologists who provide factual details on fossils. These cutaways could have been tedious, leaving the viewer just wanting to get back to the dinosaurs, but it wisely keeps them few and brief, never distracting from the mood of the rest of the movie. Another interesting thing about this one is that sometimes the story stops and takes a minute to analyze the anatomy of the dinosaurs. We get a 3D model of the creature and some x-rays highlighting a few of their unique features and abilities. It keeps the transitions consistent and knows exactly when to use them, just like with the paleontological cutaways. Like my Walking with Dinosaurs review, I'll now go through each segment to talk about them all individually. The Triassic sequence is relatively plotless, focusing on a coelophysis as it wanders around on a typical day, passing by and interacting with some of the other creatures. I'm not sure if this was the filmmaker's intention or not, but the way the first part starts out slow actually does allow the audience to ease into the movie and get used to the tone. It takes its time to let you grow accustomed to the world it's trying to create before getting into multiple creatures and complex stories. Again, I'm not sure if that's what they were trying to do, but it works in the movie's favor nonetheless. Next, we travel to the Jurassic to see a hunt in the jungle. A step up from the first part, we now see more dinosaurs and more of a story with a beginning, middle, and end. I can't talk about this segment without saying how much I love the Dilophosaurus in this part. The skin texture is very detailed, and it seems to have a silvery metallic shine to it. Not to mention it has the coolest roar in the movie. The third part is probably the most complex story out of all of them. Dinosaurs in the late Jurassic struggle through a drought in the first half, then in the second half, the wet season arrives and life flourishes again. We follow two herds of sauropods, a family of dryosauruses constantly dodging a ceratosaurus, and a male stegosaurus trying to impress a female. Despite its bleak outlook and dull color scheme, it has enough interesting stories and plenty of beautiful shots of the apatosaurus herd. The fourth segment takes us into the Cretaceous period to meet some dinosaurs never before used in a dinosaur movie. Zuniceratops, a two-horned relative of Triceratops, a pack of feathered raptors, the first ever to be used in an animated dinosaur documentary, and Nothornicus, one of the most bizarre dinosaurs ever found. I remember being completely taken by surprise seeing these weird dinosaurs that I never knew existed when I was a kid, and it made me realize I didn't know as much about them as I thought I did. There's also a terrific climax involving a forest fire sending the dinosaurs stampeding. It's nice to see that instead of CGI fire in a CGI forest, footage of an actual forest fire was used for most of it. The one thing I was a bit skeptical about, though, was the part where the raptors ignore the flames because they were too busy eating, resulting in them being burned alive. Considering the raptors were supposedly intelligent, I find it hard to believe that they would actually be that careless. I mean, have there been any instances in real life of animals ignoring imminent danger because they were busy eating? But that's really the only flaw in what is otherwise an entertaining scene. The final Cretaceous segment is nothing short of amazing. It's practically flawless. Not only does it feature the big favorites like T-Rex and Triceratops, not only is the landscape beautiful, but it also has a great story that completes the film so perfectly. First of all, I like the fact that they have the T-Rex actually lose in the first part. We all see the beast as the invincible king of the dinosaurs, but as the narrator puts it,
chasing prey for a living is a chancy business. Even carnivores like T-Rex are not always successful.
It also has an awesome extinction scene. This is more of what the ending of Walking with Dinosaurs should have been like. We see explosions and fire raining from the skies, and it really takes its time to dwell on the emptiness left by the destruction afterwards. It really makes you feel sad to see the dinosaurs go after being with them for an hour and a half. But then the tone starts to change as we see the small creatures who survived, including the mammals who will now rule the Earth, and it finally ends with a very sincere homage to the dinosaurs we just saw. It's the absolute perfect send-off to what's been a wonderful journey.
It's unlikely anything so huge or captivating will ever pass this way again.
Like I said before, When Dinosaurs Roamed America was one of my favorite dinosaur movies growing up. And after seeing it again after so many years, the experience is just as delightful as I remember. I highly recommend it to anyone who's ever been fascinated by dinosaurs.
This is Dino of the Flintstones.
I see what you did there, guys.